Hello friends, I am Dr. Amit Gangwal, the designer and instructor for this course, Artificial Intelligence and Drug Discovery. In this course, there are total 4 units followed by 2 practice tests. Unit first is Disruptive Innovations and Industry 4.0 Devolution. Second unit is Artificial Intelligence. Third is Application of Artificial Intelligence in Medical Imaging and Pharmaceutical Sciences, particularly from drug discovery point of view. And the fourth and last chapter is Artificial Intelligence, Ethics and IPR, that is Intellectual Property Rights. And this, there will be 2 practice tests, 1 and 2. So in this video, we will talk about unit first, that is Disruptive Innovations and Industry 4.0 Revolution. The chapters are Disruptive Innovations, Industry 4.0 Revolution, Blockchain, 3D organ printing and precision medicine. Lot many examples have been used, and what is the reason for this disruptive innovation, that we will see in the last part of this unit first video. So we are starting with disruptive innovations or disruptive technology. So what is the meaning of disruptive innovation? A product will be called disruptive, or the technique will be called disruptive innovation if it creates new product or new products, creates new services, or shows new way to do business by generating sale, by increasing number of customer, by increasing profit, or by minimizing the efforts to make new customer. With minimum efforts, you are making good product, good service and good profit. Or at the extreme level, if that innovation remove the old businesses or entirely changes the way work is being done, then this is called disruption, and the process is called disruptive technology or disruptive innovation. So can you think examples of this type of disruption in market, in any of the field, in pharma field particularly? Okay, we will see in coming slides. According to world famous Harvard Business Review, that is HBR, disruptive innovation is a process by which a smaller company, one with fewer resources, manages to overtake or successfully compete with incumbent enterprises. Means there is one company in the market with limited resources, limited funding, limited budget and limited number of manpower, but they have some powerful idea, data and facts and figures. On that basis, they can even topple or challenge the existing player. Number 2, smart disruptors improve their products and drive up market. Some disruptive innovations succeed and some don't. Disruptors often build business models that are very different from those of incumbents. What is incumbent? The current or existing players, current or existing way of doing business, current or existing way to sell or manufacture some products or services. Disruptive innovations do not catch on with mainstream customers until quality catches up to their standards. It means customers will not take your ideas hand to hand until they are satisfied from viewpoint of affordability and from viewpoint of some comfort or compliance in their life. Disruptive innovations originate in low end or new market footholds. Disruption describes a process whereby a smaller company with fewer resources is able to successfully challenge established incumbent businesses. Disruptive innovations are made possible because they get started in 2 types of market that existing players overlook. There are 2 types of areas where existing players are not concentrating, and here lies the opportunity for the newcomer, for the new player having good idea. So the first is new market footholds. Disruptors create a market where none existed. They find a way to turn non-customers into customers. For example, Netflix, a world famous out of the top type of video streaming platform, having lot many customers, and it has shown light to most of other successors like Amazon Prime. Then Apple is also coming with their streaming platform. ZTV has come in India. Then Idea has there, and there is Times of India purchased recently Max Player. So these are the examples of those type of disruptions which totally or literally created a new customer base. Low end footholds exist because Incumbents typically try to provide their most profitable and demanding customers with ever improving products and services, and they pay less attention to less demanding customers. The best example is Airbnb. Now we will see few examples of our surrounding from pharmacy, non-pharmacy and other field, which are the best quotable example for disruptive innovation. So in the left column, you are seeing in red, the examples of innovations are the devices or the machines which force the existing system or players to change their modus operandi. For example, personal computer. They were disrupting for the typewriters, cell phones. We all know that cell phone is now a replacement for fax, telegram, landline phone. They have also threatened industries, manufacturing personal diaries, alarms, MP3 players, calculators and cameras. ATM almost entirely ended the concept of visiting bank for various financial purposes. I hope you will agree with me that 90% customers who have to withdraw the money, they stop visiting the banks. They just use the facility of ATM. Similarly, email, laptop, wearable devices, portable devices, another technique. ECG, step trackers and lot many health and fitness recording is easily available in wristwatches, cell phones. Handheld devices are going to rule the healthcare domain, especially diagnostic paradigms. Portable foldable devices will be used by the patients. Online and e-pharmacy. No need to visit nearby pharmacy if you have valid digitally signed prescription of the doctor. Similarly, the last innovation in this table is of penless shots. Top pharma company, top diagnostic companies and top technology companies are busy in finding a solution for example, for diabetics who has to check their diabetes sugar level twice in a day by piercing by needle in their thigh, by taking the blood sample from their fingertip. So still company are trying to make it fully painless experience. So these are the examples of disruptive innovations, how they have changed the market equations. At the same time, disruptive innovations comes with certain disadvantages. They have some drawbacks which are not visible in near future post their advent in the market or society. Few examples I am sharing here. Huge discussion is going on about increasing number of cancer victims owing to mobile radiations, irreversible damage to environment owing to use of single-use plastic. But years ago, when plastic and its uses were propagated, at that time it was not thought that such a widespread use of plastic may damage environment in a irreversible manner. It means certainly that artificial intelligence, AI, machine learning, ML and Internet of Things, IoT may also have some ill effects in future. It requires visionary approach and not the myopic calculation to gauge and check the mal effects of these innovations in future. So in this slide, you will see the ill effects of plastic. Every day we are reading a newspaper in so-and-so ocean, in river, there were plastic found in the river or in the basin of the sea or from so-and-so fish, they have recovered a lot many kilograms of plastic. So these are the disadvantages definitely which are not thought before the invention. Now, what experts have to say about disruptive innovations and AI? So, as per the legendary scientist Stephen Hawking, success in creating artificial intelligence, that is AI, would be the biggest event in the human history. Unfortunately, it might also be the last unless we learn how to avoid the risk. It is same how you are using science or your weapons either for mass destruction or for social welfare, humanity, for mankind. It decides the risk benefit ratio. As per the famous consultancy firm audit firm PwC, by 2030 the global GDP could rise by 14% as a result of AI enabled activities, that is equal to $15.7 trillion. As per Sundar Pichai, recently promoted chief executive officer of Google, AI will be more transformative to humanity than electricity. As per the Masayoshi Son, the SoftBank honcho, Japan should make AI a mandatory subject for college entrance examination. Such is the need of AI that it should be covered in syllabus of school as per the Miyoshi San, the chief position holding person at SoftBank. As per Accenture, explainable AI will not replace human workers. Rather, it will complement and support people so they can make better, faster and more accurate decisions. AI technology can enhance business productivity up to 40%. Means those people who are saying AI will remove the jobs, it will not be like that, because AI machines are being built by people only, and whenever there is need of explainable AI, there will be use of human expert. Now these are the some brands or the companies which have entirely changed the system of business which were earlier being done by the incumbent. So these are the global and local brands: Alibaba, Flipkart and Amazon. They have changed the way people purchase the materials. Uber, Ola and Didi, they are the taxi aggregators. They have changed the way we commute, we do transportation. Khan Academy, Baiju, Unacademy, they are the online learning platforms. But today they are the giants in their category, but they started as a startup. As I told, as per the definition, limited setup, limited area, limited resources, limited fund, but a very mind-blowing idea was there behind their success. Google Pay, Paytm and Bheem. Then we have the example of personal assistant from various company, like Amazon has given Alexa, Apple has given Siri, the Alphabet managed company Google has given Google Assistant, and Cortana is an assistant by Samsung. Now Swiggy and Uber Eats, they are the organizations engaged in home delivery of the foods. Then online pharmacy, also called e-pharmacy in India, they are 1MG, Netmedicine, MedLife. Similarly, as I told you, out of the above the platform streaming player, we have the Netflix and Amazon Prime and Apple TV Plus. So these are the examples of disruptive innovations, and this is possible because of the advent of ABCD. What is ABCD? A stands for artificial intelligence, B for blockchain, C for coding algorithms, and D for data analytics. We will see in next chapters what is the meaning of all these terminologies. Last example is Big Basket and Grofer. So they are the home delivery organizations. One biggest benefit that we are seeing right now in March 2020 around the world is that because of unexpected outbreak of corona, which is now a pandemic, all these online delivery, online facility providers are becoming the boon for the people who are almost caged in their homes as part of social distancing. Now the next is Industry 4.0 revolution. Industry 4.0 revolution is after Industry 1, 2 and 3. So this is the progression of various industrial development, and all this Industry 4.0 revolution is becoming possible because of AI, high speed internet, machine learning, cloud computing and quantum computing. So what is Industry 1, 2, 3 and 4.0? This is various progressions in industrial setup. So I will talk about Industry 4.0, which is the latest way of industrialization. What is it? This is the era of disruptive innovations or disruptive technologies. This is based on high speed internet connectivity, that is 5G, cloud computing, big data analytics, Internet of Things, artificial intelligence, machine learning, 3D organ printing, blockchain and related technological advancement like virtual reality and augmented reality. Such is the application of these innovations that none of the industries and none of the department have untouched or immune to these disruptions, and pharmaceutical industries are not an exception. Moving on to second topic, that is blockchain, 3D organ printing and precision medicine. So some of the innovations which are disrupting healthcare sectors are blockchain, 3D organ printing, precision medicine, robotic surgeries, robot assistance for geriatrics and patients of nervous system disorders and other disorders which require attending with the patient. So here attendance role will be done by, or it is already being done by, robots to make the life of such patients easier. Handheld devices and wearable devices like Apple Watch to track various biological parameters. So what is blockchain? As the image indicates, blocking of the transactions. Each transaction is called block. I will tell you in next section. This is the infographic. For example, for indicating blockchain basics, A wants to send money to B, then the transaction is represented as a block. How this blockchain terminology came into picture? A transaction wants to be done for B by A. The transaction is represented as block. Then next is, the transaction is broadcasted to a network of nodes. That is, computer is called node here. Fourth is, the network validates the transaction. That is, the transaction is valid. There is no fraud. There is no hacking. Sufficient balance is there. There is no, the breach of the privacy. It is checked by step number 4. Step number 5. Now the block can be added to the blockchain in a way that is permanent and unalterable. Each block indicates a validated transaction. After transaction is over, there is no tampering. Even during transaction, there is no tampering. So this is the way to ensure tampering proof transaction of data. And the sixth step is, the money moves from A to B in a safe manner. So here is the further clarification. What is blockchain? Blockchain is a collection of records linked with each other, not prone or vulnerable to any alteration or fraud by anybody, owing to protection by cryptography. So the best example of blockchain is cryptocurrency. One type of cryptocurrency is Bitcoin. People in a wrong manner understand that blockchain is synonym with Bitcoin, but it is not like that. Rather, Bitcoin was the success example of blockchain. So cryptocurrency is a form of digital or virtual currency. Different cryptocurrencies use different hashing algorithm for private and public key. There are two types of keys in blockchain which are used to ensure tamper-proof transaction. Transaction blocks are linked to each other, as I have shown in last infographic. Chain or records or blocks is called a ledger. Ledger shared among all involved parties form the basis for blockchain. Now there is two concept, mining and proof of work. What is mining? To add a block to a blockchain. What is block? Individual transaction. To add a block to the blockchain is called mining. And the miners, that is the human beings, ensure this job by solving a complex mathematical problem so that no one can do hacking, no one can tamper the data or those type of transaction. And proof of work, process to solve this complex mathematical problem is called proof of work. Applications of blockchain in healthcare, medical supply chain management and drug traceability, safety. Breakthrough in genomics lead to lot many data. So there should be proper safety and transaction of those data for further research in medical field. And this is as lots of data to be safely stored without any tampering. Securing patient data as well, clinical trial management, because lot of data are generated during preclinical and clinical phase. So huge data is generated which is to be saved. The manufacturing supply chain, a logistics nightmare. It is very difficult for a logistic person to ensure proper supply chain, which involves basically the risk of tampering of the packets or other materials. So this will lead to proper tamper-free supply of the goods. Public safety and consumer awareness, inventory management from the raw material receiving to finished good sending to the customer, and drug safety, how drugs are manufactured. Now we are moving to latest disruption in the healthcare industry, that is 3D organ printing. So this diagram indicates how 3D organs are printed. 3D printing means using proper design in the computer, using computer aided designing. There is proper prototype or scaffold is designed on system. Then that scaffold is transformed to the actual physical material using various raw material. If I talk about 3D printing application in pharmacy or health science, then there is the 3D printing of your organ. Yes, in next 10 years, perhaps you will be able to produce your own 3D heart, 3D kidney in for your body if you are unfortunately losing your kidney or heart because of disease. So these are the very steps I have shown in this figure. This is taken from the original creator. Infographics is very, very beautiful. There are hard material. Then there is hydrogel, which is the main component of this organ printing. There is bio ink and soft material. So there is binder droplets, then construction of scaffolds, that is the structure, then cell seeding, culturing, implantation in regenerated tissues. If we talk about the formation of major organs, then we have to harvest tissue from the organ, we have to decellularization, then we have to solubilize in pH, we have to adjust the pH. Then we have to further go for differentiation, redifferentiation, ultimately to get the structure. Still, it is in investigation phase. There is no approved 3D organ printing system or machine or company in the world by any of the authority. It is under investigation. And in next 10 years, perhaps we will be able to see this in market. So steps, again, I am summarizing. Create a blueprint of an organ with its vascular architecture. What type of blood cells are there? What is required to nourish that organ? All those things, structure, cellular layer, tissue layer. Then there is differentiate the stem cell into organ specific cells. Prepare bio ink reservoirs with organ specific cells, blood vessels and support medium and load them into printer. Third step is bioprinting, that is place the bioprinted organ in a bioreactor prior to transplantation. The most important and talked about feature in pharmacy is now precision medicine. So there are three types of treatment. Symptom based medicine, suppose there are 100 people suffering from fever, doctor will prescribe paracetamol to all the people. There is no genetic guideline, no genetic makeup checking, no genome sequencing, just based on symptom. You are suffering from fever, will prescribe some OTC or other type of material. It is called symptom-based medicine. Second is evidence-based medicine. There is some detailed study, then treatment might be different for different patients for same disorder. Third one, which is the future, is called precision medicine, which is algorithm-based medicine based on your genetic makeup, based on your history, based on your cellular structure, your DNA sequencing, might be possible different type of medicines will be given to different patient. For example, there can be 10 patients of blood cancer, but there might be different symptoms, might be same, disease is same, for example, blood cancer, but there might be different origin or etiology, that is the disease progression. There might be the chances of different type of gene mutation for same cancer. So one medicine will not be effective for all type of those blood cancer patients. So precision medicine is a medical concept that recommends the customization of healthcare with medical decisions, including treatments, practices or products being tailored to the individual patients. And this is different from one size fits to all. Now, drug response differences among different individuals groups are influenced by several features like allele frequency, differences of single nucleotide polymorphism, etc. Here comes the concept of precision medicine. As per the experts, the global precision medicine market size is predicted to be $119.90 US billion. Progression in genomic and proteomic sequencing with reduced treatment cost is the main reason for catching up of this precision medicine. Now there is how this is done. Molecular fingerprinting is done, then using algorithm of AI, using big data analytics and reference material databases. There is mobile information communication technologies and precision medicine. So these are the steps responsible for devising exact what type of medicines are to be devised. Now, handheld devices on wearable devices. These are the future. This type of devices, the way, as I told you earlier in earlier session, the way we stopped visiting banks for withdrawing money, we are relying only on ATM. Similarly, for small diagnostic tests, or investigation from biochemistry point of view, for example, blood profile, lipid profile, heart rate, and other pulse rate, there is a huge market. There is wristwatches in which the leading player is Apple. technology giant. They have produced the special watches which will not only show the time but also will track your various biological, biochemical and physiological activities. So there are less and less chances in coming years that we will visit to doctor for ECG, for lipid profile, for sugar level. Directly we will touch the sensor and it will show the reading. Companies are working on this model. If I talk about the innovative product of Apple company, that is the Apple Watch, then Apple sold nearly 10 million more watches than the entire Swiss watch industry in 2019. And it is a sign that wristwear market has entirely changed. So this is the example of disruptive innovation or disruption. A new player in watch category is Apple. Apple is the youngest player for watch company in the world. So this is now changing the entire way watches are made, watches are sold. So now if Swiss companies have to survive, they have to learn something from the Apple. This is the example of disruptive innovation. Now, what is the driving force for all these innovations? What suddenly happened? So there is the behind the curtain, there is technologies like artificial intelligence, AI, machine learning, ML and IoT, Internet of Things, cloud computing and high speed quantum system and fast connectivity of internet. These are the catalysts or the enzymes or the vitamins for this type of innovation, because they are giving speed, they are giving sensor capacities and they are having the capacity to analyze huge data and extract. This is important. After analyzing huge data, to extract the limited and highly accurate information from huge data, this is not capable, this is not the capacity of human mind. So this high level of computation in millisecond is possible by AI only. This is the reason for success of these innovations. Now I am leaving you now with various beautifully illustrated original infographics of CB Insights, worldwide famous organizations for doing research study on its own in an original manner is CB Insights. They indicate hundreds of organizations which are changing different areas of healthcare through smarter technologies. So this is the information, brand names and logos of the healthcare startups who are doing something great in the healthcare through AI. This is the digital hospital. 82 companies worldwide are reinventing the practice of medicine. They are the brand names and logos of companies which are using blockchain, AI, machine learning to make people's life easier. These are the companies and logos who are doing something wonderful in medical device. This is the Internet of Things market map as per CB Insights. And anatomy of the healthcare startups. These are the other healthcare startups who are making people's life easier from viewpoint of treatment, prevention and diagnosis of lot many disorders. This is the mobile healthcare market, various applications in the smartphone, they are doing life easier. And they are the startups who are busy in microbiome. And this is the last section of first unit. What are the uses of AI in drug discovery? That we will see in chapter number 3. In chapter number 2, we will see basics of AI and other related terminologies. So application of AI in drug discovery, organic synthesis and design, scoring synthetic complexity, automation of molecule design, predicting organic reaction outcomes, computer aided synthesis, computer assisted retrosynthesis, predict drug performance in testing, discover off-label uses, that is repurposing. One of the most important uses of AI is repurposing, that is to analyze the unexpected indication or use of a drug molecule for which it was not approved in the market. So recent example is, for example, as per WHO and as per ICMR India, the use of chloroquine, the use of hydroxychloroquine and use of azithromycin has been recommended for treatment or for decreasing the symptoms or alleviating the symptoms of coronavirus.